Let's make Short Course great again. Rich here from the RCNetwork.com, and this is my second video now on the ProStar RC conversion kit for the Techno ET 410 or 410.2. Now, this is actually a conversion kit that converts a baby truggy into a full-fledged short course truck, a four-wheel drive or a two-wheel drive. Now, I am making this into a four-wheel drive kind of lightweight short course truck just to compete out there and to have some fun. Now, if you haven't already done so, please check out my unboxing or actually unpackaging video of this kit. It shows you everything that kind of comes with the kit, a lot of option parts that you will see in this video, just so you don't get confused at what comes with the kit and what doesn't. You can reference that video. I'll have that in the upper right hand corner or down in the video description. Now, just to make you aware of some of the things about this kit. Now, there's not really any instructions that come with it. You definitely get some good pictures and some descriptions of the parts, but there's not really like a step-by-step build sheet for this. And that's kind of what I'm doing in this video. I'm gonna take you step by step on how I built mine so far, and then obviously the next video we'll see all the electronics installed, maybe body, some wheels and tires, and that type of thing. Now, if you are building your own, definitely reference the Facebook page. I'll have a link to that down below as well as the ProStar RC website. Lots of photos on that website that kind of show you the ins and outs of this kit. I've definitely referenced them a few times myself. One of the most frequent questions I got was how much longer is the ProStar RC conversion chassis. Now, laying the ET410.2 chassis on top of it, you can see here you definitely add some length, about 1 inch and 5/16 is about the length that you add to this chassis. You also get quite a bit of width there, especially towards the rear of this chassis. So no more mixing up which way your car is pointed. It's pretty obvious with the ProStar chassis. So when I started my build, I actually disassembled my entire ET410.2. I actually took out all the screws from the bottom of the chassis and kind of laid them out, so I exactly knew what screw went where when I was doing the reassembly of it. Now, not all screws are included in the conversion kit, so definitely have a few extras on hand. I'll try and point that out as we go through this video on which ones I did have to add, but I may miss a couple. So once you have everything removed from the bottom of the chassis, you'll pretty much be ready to start on your conversion. I kind of laid it out in a big carcass right there. I had the screws off to the side, and now is starting my build. The first thing I started with was the 3D printed battery brace that goes on the very back of the truck. Now, I am doing a rear biased setup for four-wheel drive, so that puts the battery in the far back passenger side of the actual RC. Now, you do utilize that front mount that came on it. You just kind of flip it around, turn it around to the other side. Everything fit like a glove. I put in a test battery right there, the Jens Ace Redline 6000 milliamp battery. Thing fits in like a glove. Second thing I did was mount the center differential, the motor plate, and the center diff upright. Once again, flipping it around so that the motor will be in the driver's side rear of the vehicle. That's what's so cool about these techno vehicles. Everything can kind of be mirrored, flipped around, and you have a definite advantage as far as weight bias now with this new ProStar conversion kit. The cool thing was when I put in the center differential, it kind of clicked into place, which was really nice. It kind of shows the attention to detail and the accuracy of his conversion chassis plate. Next, I mounted the front clip of the ET410. After I removed some of the plastic parts that I'm going to replace with those cool blue carbon fiber pieces. The ET410.2 chassis has that little locking feature at the front of the A block. However, the ProStar chassis doesn't have that, so you don't have to back off the A block to remount it. The front shock tower and front camber plate in the blue carbon fiber went on quite nicely. Snug fit, everything just sandwiches in nicely. Mounting the top deck from the ProStar kit, it fit really snugly, actually kind of snapped into place, especially back towards the center differential. The center diff portion only took two screws to mount it, as the new rear chassis brace uses the other screws and actually uses countersunk, a little bit longer length screws to mount that. The wire retainer for the battery wires did have to be clipped off for the center chassis plate to sit flush. It took me a little while to figure that out, but finally just clipped it off with some wire cutters and I was set to go. The rear center brace is a work of of art. It's actually made from carbon fiber and some 3D printed parts, but the brace has been milled out to allow the rear center drive shaft to kind of peek on through it. I mounted the 3D part on the center diff first, then loosely placed the brace on. Once again, using the hardware not supplied, the part fit absolutely perfect. Now it's time to put the rear clip on there. I prepared the rear clip by replacing the shock tower with the new blue carbon fiber version. The tower has the camber plate built into it, so one less thing to add on. I also added the brass C-block to the clip, and just like the rest, it fit perfect. It does look a bit odd being bright gold though. Next, mounting the rear clip took a bit of time, as the use of the team associated rear drive shaft would be needed. You'll need the 82mm version, not the 95 that's included kind of in the kit. I did come up to my first hiccup in the actual mounting of this. The ET4 10.2 comes with solid outdrive couplers versus the ET4 10 that had kind of that relief cut or lightened version. The team associated drive shafts wouldn't quite fit in all the way like I liked them. They weren't loose fitting, in other words. After a few double checks with Nick, one of the team drivers from ProStar, I decided to break out the Dremel and sand down the rear drive shaft bulb of the actual drive shaft. The pins were fine, just the bulb of the drive shaft was too large. You can also pick up the old version of the Techno outdrive and coupler to avoid this if you have an ET4 10.2. Once I mounted the rear clip, everything clicked in and it started to look like an SCT chassis at last. Now, one setup item I addressed was the wheelbase. The ET4 10.2 has the spacer set on the hinge pins at the shortest wheelbase possible. You'll want to flip that to the longest possible, stacking the spacers on the inside, moving the arms to the furthest point. I noticed the rear arms were actually hitting before I did this. I also changed that on the front end as well. Starting with the front body mount, I used the Techno SCT410 front shock tower body mount for the front of this SCT conversion. It was not a direct fit, so you will have to modify it to fit. I used a silver Sharpie and kind of sharpied where I didn't need the actual part of the body mount and just cut it out with a nice sharp hobby knife. I took small cuts just to make sure I had a precise fit and kept test fitting until I got it perfect. I was really pleased how this mounted up, almost like it was meant to be. For the rear body mount, I used the team associated version. It matched the bolt pattern to one set of the screws on the rear tower. It would have been nice if all four screw holes were matching the tower, but it seems pretty strong the way it is with just the two screws and the lock nuts mounted to the front of it. As far as the recommended bumpers, I decided to scrap those. Looking at how they would mount on, it just wasn't going to be ideal. Especially after a few missed landings, I think they would actually come off. So I have some new bumpers on their way here that I think might do the trick. And they're actually meant for the ET or EB lineup of vehicles. Well guys, there it is. That is my short course conversion kit for the ET4 10.2. I can't wait to get everything installed on this. Definitely have some bumpers to mount. I have a body to paint, electronics to wire up, some wheels and tires to glue up, and get you a final video of how it looks before it hits the track. But as always, I'd love to hear your thoughts on the conversion kit, or if you have some cool ideas, drop those on down below in the comment section. Now, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you'll be alerted anytime I upload a video. And finally, my name is Rich. Thanks for watching.